ओम श्री साई राम। माय मोस्ट हम्बल प्रणाम एट द लोटस डिवाइन फीट ऑफ मदर साई। टुडे वी हैव टू स्टार्ट आवर कंप्यूटर क्लास। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू डू थ्री ओमकार्स। ऑल ऑफ यू जॉइन योर हैंड्स, क्लोज योर आईज। Sairam, today we start our lesson number 3, Exploring Windows 7. Lesson number 3, Exploring Windows 7. In this lesson, we learn about the Windows Explorer, navigation in Windows Explorer, creating files and folders, renaming files and folders, deleting files and folders, restoring files and folders, copying and moving files and folders, creating shortcuts. All that things we have to learn in this chapter. So now we start the chapter. You work with several files and folders on a computer. Where does the computer store them all? Can you manage the file and folders? Yes, you can. Windows has an application that you can use to manage these items. This application is called Windows Explorer. You can use Windows Explorer to create, copy, delete, move, and rename files and folders. First of all, we have to learn about the opening Windows Explorer. In the computer, we can manage our files. We can create, copy, and all that things we can do on a computer in Windows Explorer. That program name is Windows Explorer. How do you open the Windows Explorer? To open Windows Explorer, follow these steps. Number 1. Click on the start button. Number 2, point to all programs. Number 3, a list of options appears. Click on accessories in the list. Number 4, from the list of accessories, click on the Windows Explorer option. The Windows Explorer window opens. These are steps to open the Windows Explorer. You have to follow this step to open the Windows Explorer. First of all, click on the start button, then all programs, then accessories. In the accessories, you can see the Windows Explorer option. Another option is there to open the Windows Explorer. You can also click on the Windows Explorer icon on the taskbar. To open Windows Explorer, that icon you can see in the picture quick tip. This is the Windows Explorer option where you can click and directly open the Windows Explorer. Next is Windows Explorer window. The Windows Explorer window is divided into two columns or panes. The pane on the left is called the navigation pane. It displays the available drives, folders, and subfolders. The pane on the right is called the file list pane. You can see in this picture, this is the screen of Windows Explorer and it is divided into two parts. This is the left side. In the left side, you can see the navigation pane. It displays the available drives, folders, and subfolders. And this is the right side. This is called file list pane. and there are some other parts of the Windows Explorer: search box, address bar, toolbar, forward button, back button, navigation pane, status bar, and file list pane. To view the content of any folder or drive, click on it in the navigation pane. The file list pane will display the content of the selected folder. If you want to see the content of folder, you have to click on your folder or drive on navigation pane. Then you can see the content in a list pane, file list pane. Whatever contents in that particular folder or drive, you can see in a file list pane. That will be displayed in a file list pane of your selected folder. Next is creating file and folder. How to create a file or folder? In your previous class, standard 4, you also learned how to create a file and folder. The same process in Windows Explorer also. To create a file or folder, follow these steps. Number 1, click on computer in the navigation pane. Number 2, click on a drive where you want to create a file. Next, right click on the blank area in the file list pane. Click on new. Then click on a type of file from the menu that appears. A new file will be created. Give a name to the file and press the enter key. Your file will be created. Here is the given the steps how to create a new file. First of all, click on the My Computer, then select the drive. Then after, right click on the blank area. Then after, you have to select a new option. Then after, select a file. Which type file you want to create, you have to select from here. And then after, type the name and press the enter key. After the pressing enter key, your file will be created. Now, how to create a folder? To create a folder, follow these steps. Right click on the blank area on the file list pane. Click on new option. Click on new folder from the menu that appears. A new folder will be created. Give a name to the folder and press the enter key. Same to same process are there, but here you have to select a folder, not a file. If you click on the file will be created. Otherwise, you have to click on a folder to create a folder. And you can also give the name to your folder, whatever you want. After creating a folder, you want to change the name of your folder or file, you can change it. One option is there that called as a rename option. To rename your file or folder, follow these steps. Number 1, click on file or the folder to select it. Click on organize on the toolbar. Then after, click on rename option. Type the desired name for the folder and press the enter key to rename it. If you want to rename your file or folder, follow these steps. One another option is there to rename your file or folder. You have to select your file or folder and directly right click on that particular file or folder. One dialog box is there. You have to select rename option and then after you can type your new name of your file or folder. Next is deleting files and folders. To delete a file or folder, follow these steps. All of you know how to delete your file or folder. Yes. Some steps are here. You have to follow this. Number 1, click on the file or folder you wish to delete. Click on Organize on the toolbar. Click on Delete. A Delete Folder dialog box appears. Click on Yes to delete the item. A deleted file or folder is moved to the recycle bin. It stays there until you delete it again from there. To delete your file or folder, first of all you have to select your file or folder which you want to delete. Then after, two options are there. One is you can right click of your mouse and one dialog box is there. You have to select the delete option. And another way is there, you can select your file or folder and directly press the delete button from your keyboard. Whenever you want to delete your file or folder, a computer asks you a confirmation message. If you want to delete your file or folder, click on Yes, otherwise click on the No button. If you click on Yes, your file will be deleted, or your deleted file or folder is moved to your recycle bin. If you by mistake delete your file or folder, you can restore from the recycle bin. Once you deleted your file or folder from the recycle bin, you cannot get back that file or folder. Here is checkpoint is there. You have to write this checkpoint on your notebook. Next is restoring files and folders. You can bring back file and folders that you have deleted. This is called restoring a file or folder. Can only be restored if you have not deleted it from the recycle bin. I already tell you, if you delete your file from the recycle bin, you cannot be restore your file or folder. If your file or folder is in recycle bin, you can restore it. To restore it, follow these steps. Double click on the recycle bin icon on the desktop to open the recycle bin. In the recycle bin window, click on the file or folder you want to restore. Then after, click on Restore this item on the toolbar. Your file or folder will be restored their original place. Next is copying files and folders. To copy a file or a folder, follow these steps. Number 1, select the file or folder you want to copy. Number 2, click on Organize in the toolbar. Number 3, click on Copy. Number 4, open the folder where you want the selected file or folder to be copied. Click on Organize on the toolbar. Click on Paste to copy the file or folder to the desired location. These are steps to copy your file or folder. You can also use the shortcut keys. There are shortcut keys. Copy Ctrl C, and for the paste you can use the Ctrl V. One thing remember students, whenever you want to copy any file or folder, first of all you have to select it. Without selection you cannot do anything. First of all you have to select your file or folder, then after you can do any other. After the selecting your file or folder, you have to press the Ctrl C, means your file or folder will be copied. And then after, where you want to the copy of your file or folder, you have to open that drive or folder and press the Ctrl V to paste that copied file or folder. Next is moving file and folders. You can move files and folders from one location to another. For example, let us move a file name Tulip from a folder named Flower to another folder named My Picture. To move file, follow these steps. Click on the file name Tulip. Click on Organize on the toolbar. Click on Cut. Double click on the My Picture folder to open where you want to move the file or folder. Click on Organize on the toolbar. Click on Paste. This process is also called cut and paste. Before this process, we learn about the copy paste, and this is the cut paste. Means you have to cut your file from one location to, and you can move that file another location. In the copying, your file will be in the both location, or in the cut, you have to cut file from the original location and you move that file into the new location. You can also use the shortcut key to cut and paste. First of all, select your file or folder. Then after, press the Ctrl X. Ctrl X is the shortcut key for the cut. Then after, select the location where you want to paste that file. And then after, press the Ctrl V to paste the particular file. Next is creating shortcuts. A shortcut is a link to an item on your computer. The item can be a file, folder, or program. Clicking on a shortcut will take you straight to the item it is linked to. This allows you to access the item easily and quickly. Shortcut icon have an arrow on them. This makes them look different from the original file. Creating shortcut. All of you know about the shortcut? Yes. Some files and folders you have to open repeatedly, and there are so many times you using that, you need that file or folder. That time you can create a shortcut on your desktop. That particular file or folder. To create that shortcut, follow these steps. Right click on the item for which you want to create a shortcut. Place the cursor over Send to and click on Desktop. The shortcut of the item appears on the desktop. And how to know this is shortcut or not? In the shortcut icon, you have an arrow on them. You can look in a picture, this arrow, you have an arrow on them, means this is the shortcut file or folder. Whenever you click on this file or folder, you can directly go on a original file. You can open original file or folder from this shortcut. Now keywords are there. Windows Explorer, an application used to organize file and folder, that's called as a Windows Explorer. In a computer, to organize your file or folders, all that things, that program is there, that name is Windows Explorer. Next is navigation pane. The pane on the Windows Explorer windows that displays the available drive, folders and subfolder, that's called as a navigation pane. File list pane, the pane on the Windows Explorer windows that displays the content of the selected drive or folders, that's called as a file list pane. Next is recycle bin, the place we used to store the deleted item on the computer, that's called as a recycle bin. It is the dustbin of computer. Shortcut, a link to an item such as file, folder or program, that's called as a shortcut. Shortcut is a link to open an original file or folder or any program. You have to write keywords on your notebook and summary also. Next time I will send you the whole exercise. You have to write that exercise on your notebook. Today's class is over. We have to do Om Shanti Shanti. शांति 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 ही साईराम, टेक केयर।